World's Best Warrior by Pedro Pablo Sacristán. Corky was a brave young man, an expert swordsman, and he dreamed of becoming the best fighter in the world. In the whole army, there wasn't a single soldier who could beat him. He hoped to become head of the army one day, so he could replace the cowardly old general who was currently in charge. The king liked Corky.
I would like to run your army and replace the general.
The king looked a bit shocked and said,
Your desire is sincere, but I'm afraid it can't happen right now. You still have so much to learn.
That was the worst thing that could have happened to Corky, who became so furious that he stormed out of the palace.
Aw, shucks. I'll show you and that old general.
Determined to learn all there was to know about fighting wars, he went to all kinds of schools, improving his technique and strength, but without really learning any new secrets. Until one day, he went to a very special school, a huge gray fortress on top of a great mountain. He had heard it was the best military school in the world, and only a few students were allowed to train there. On his way, he learned that the old general had studied there, and Corky proceeded, ever more determined to be accepted into the school to learn the great secrets of war. Before entering the fortress, he was made to hand in all his weapons.
You won't need those anymore. Here, you'll be getting better ones, said the guard.
Corky was impressed, and he handed his weapons to a little gray man who immediately threw them into a pit. One of the instructors, a serious old man of few words, accompanied Corky to his room. As he left, the old man said,
In 100 days, the training will start.
100 days? You've got to be kidding.
But soon, Corky realized the man had been serious. The first days were filled with nervous tension, and Corky tried all manner of silly tactics to try to get them to start the training. It didn't work, though, and he ended up waiting patiently, enjoying each day as it was. On the 101st day, the first lesson began.
You have already learned how to use your main weapon. Patience,
began the wise old teacher. Corky could hardly believe it, and he let out a brief chuckle. The old man went on to remind him of all the crazy stunts Corky had pulled in the first days, when he had been overcome by impatience.
I have to admit it. You're right,
Corky said to the teacher.
Now it's time to learn how to win every battle, said the old man.
That sounds good to me,
Corky said, until he found himself tied hand and foot to a chair, and the chair standing on top of a small pedestal, and with dozens of villagers climbing up trying to give him a good whack. He had very little time to act, and the ropes were tight. He couldn't get out of this one. The villagers climbed on the pedestal and set to work. The very same exercise was repeated for days, and Corky knew he would have to try some new tactics. He tried and failed many times, until it dawned on him the only way to prevent the attack would be to deal with the villagers' anger. In the following days, he kept talking to them.
Why do you have a beef with me? Did I do something?
He kept talking to them until he managed to convince them that he was no threat to them, but rather a friend. In the end, he was so persuasive that they gave up their hostility by themselves. And such a friendship developed that they offered to avenge Corky by turning on the teacher. It was day 202.
You already control the most powerful weapon, the weapon of words.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.